Hola amigos, ¿cómo están? Hello my friends, how are you? Okay, my name is Blanca Ventura and I am from Dominican Republic. And also I am a certified online Spanish teacher. I've been an online Spanish teacher for almost 4 years now, and I've been teaching Spanish in classrooms for 20 years. And recently, I came up with the idea of making a series of YouTube videos related to learning Spanish, okay, specifically about grammar, pronunciation, and Latin culture. And in this series of videos, I'm going to be targeting certain mistakes that I see that are very common among my students, okay? So you can be expecting that in these videos. One thing I want to say is that because here in YouTube, there is a broad audience, okay? People from different ages, cultural backgrounds, and education and learning styles. These videos, they are going to be in Spanish and English, because my point is that everybody understands and everybody learns how to speak Spanish correctly, okay, and with confidence. So now we are gonna go to our first lesson, which is about the personal pronouns in Spanish, okay? So let's go. Okay, queridos estudiantes, entonces vamos a empezar ya con a definir los pronombres personales, okay? So my dear students, let's start giving the definitions of the personal pronouns. Los pronombres personales son las palabras que sirven para hacer referencia al sujeto de la oración sin nombrarlo directamente, o los sujetos de la oración sin nombrarlos directamente. What does that mean? It means that the personal pronouns are those words that we use to substitute the noun, okay, or the subject in a sentence without referring to their names. Ejemplo, Ana. Ana es estudiante. Ana is a lady. So I'm gonna use ella. Ella es estudiante. Okay? So after we have this very clear, let's go ahead and learn the personal pronouns. Ta-dang! Okay, forma singular, singular form. Yo. Yo soy Blanca. Okay? Yo, I. Tú. Tú eres estudiante. Tú, you. Él. Él es José. Él, he. Él. Él es Toby. Es mi perro. Él, he, for a dog. Okay, now you are gonna say, how is that possible? Él. I'm gonna use él for a dog and for a person, for a man. Well, él puede sustituir cualquier sustantivo masculino singular, incluyendo cosas y animales. Él can substitute any male animal, okay, singular male noun or masculine noun, okay? Not only a man or a person. Okay, vamos a continuar. Let's continue. Forma singular. We continue with the singular form. Ella. Ella es Ana. Ella, she. Ella. Ella es Tita. Es mi gata. She. Okay, atención. Atención. Ella puede sustituir cualquier sustantivo femenino singular, incluyendo cosas y animales. That means ella can substitute as well as he, but now ella can substitute any female noun, okay? It doesn't have to be exactly a woman, all right? Okay, and now we have usted. Usted es profesor. Usted, you. Okay, now, usted is the formal form of you, of tú, ¿ok? Tú, I use it for a friend, for my brother, for my sister, and usted with my doctor, with the policeman, etc. Okay? So, don't forget that the difference between usted and tú. Let's continue. Okay, now we are gonna learn the plural form. So we have nosotros, okay? Nosotros, I'm gonna use it when I am included in the group, okay? Don't forget that. So we say, nosotros somos estudiantes, hombres, okay? I use nosotros with men, okay? All men, nosotros, we. Pedro y yo somos estudiantes, okay? So Peter and I are students. Nosotros somos estudiantes, hombres y mujeres. Now, nosotros, we include men and women, okay? And I am included with men and women. So I use nosotros also. Ramón, Ana y yo somos estudiantes. Ramón, Ana and I are students, okay? Now, nosotras. Nosotras somos estudiantes, mujeres. Nosotras for only women, okay? Ana, María y yo somos estudiantes. Ana, María and I are students. So, I can use nosotros for when we are talking like a group of men, or nosotros when we are talking about a group of men and women. When I am included, of course, and nosotras when I am included in a group of women, okay? Okay, let's continue. Now, we are gonna learn the plural form of you, right? In English, you have a you plural, right? So here we have in Spanish something called vosotros and vosotras. So, Vosotros sois estudiantes, only men. Ramón, Pedro y tú sois estudiantes. Okay? Vosotros, you plural. Vosotros sois estudiantes, men and women, hombres y mujeres. Ramón y tú sois estudiantes. Vosotras. Only girls. Vosotras sois estudiantes. María y tú sois estudiantes. Okay? Only girls. So, people. Vosotros and vosotras, as I said, is the plural form of tú and usted. And it is used mainly in Spain, okay? And it is used in an informal situation or an informal context. So you are gonna use vosotros and vosotras with your children, with your brothers and sisters, with your students, with your students, etc. Okay, so you got what I mean, right? Okay, entonces, let's continue. Okay, so now we are gonna see ustedes. Ustedes is the plural, is the you plural as well, the same like vosotros. So we have ustedes son estudiantes, only for men. Ramón, Pedro y usted o tú son estudiantes. Okay? Ustedes son estudiantes. Men and women. Ramón y usted or tú son estudiantes. Ustedes son estudiantes. Only women. María y usted or y tú son estudiantes. Okay, ustedes, it is used in whole Latin America instead of vosotros and vosotras. However, in Spain, ustedes is used in a formal context, okay? So you are gonna say, you are gonna use ustedes with your with a group of doctors or teachers or principals in the school or your grandparents and so on. So it's a very, in a very formal context, okay? Okay, so let's continue. So now we have the pronoun ellos, or ellos, they, okay? Ellos son estudiantes, only men, solo hombres. Ramón y José son estudiantes. Okay, now I'm gonna talk about men and women, and I'm gonna use ellos too. Ellos son estudiantes. Pedro y María son estudiantes. Now I'm gonna talk about my two dogs, Lolo and Pinto, okay? Ellos son Lolo y Pinto, son mis perros. So, ellos, also I can use it with male animals in plural, okay? So, I have here, they are, Lolo and Pinto, they are my dogs, okay? So, the same thing with él, ellos can be used with male animals, but in plural. Okay, now, they, but only for women or female animals or things, okay? Ellas. Ellas son estudiantes, mujeres. María y Elena son estudiantes. Ellas. Ellas son Lala y Tita. Okay? These two lovely cats. Son mis gatas. They are female cats. Okay? So, the same thing. I can use ellas with to talk about a group of women or to talk about my female cats or female animals. Okay? Okay, I hope that you understood what I said, and I hope that now it is very clear for you how to use the personal pronouns in Spanish, and that you feel confident to use it when you talk about people or animals. And now this is the moment for a mini quiz. So please hold on for 1 minute and try to complete the following quiz. So, let's try to complete it. I'm gonna give you 1 minute, and what you are gonna do is that you are going to substitute the names that you have here, like Pedro, Rosa, etc., for the correct pronoun. Okay, so I'm gonna give you like 2 minutes to complete. And here are the answers. So for number one, I'm going to choose la letra D. Él es estudiante, ¿ok? Número 2, B, ella es mi amiga. Número 3, E, nosotros hablamos inglés. Número 4, F, ustedes son dominicanos. Número 5, C, ellas son peruanas. Número 6. G. Nosotras somos secretarias. Número 7. A. Ellos son médicos. Número 8. A. Ellos son hermanos. ¿Ok? Did you get them all correct? I am sure you did. Okay, guys, I hope that you learn all about the personal pronouns in Spanish, and now that you have no doubt about how to use the pronoun él when you refer to male animals, or ella when you refer to a female animal, okay? And well, if you want to have your own online Spanish class, you can contact me in my Gmail that you saw during the whole video, or also through Instagram. And I invite you to click on subscribe right there on this YouTube channel, so you won't miss the next video that I'm gonna be making about the verb ser in Spanish, which is a very important verb that is equal to the verb to be in English. And definitely you should not miss that video, okay? So thank you so much and see you.